We have two more parts to put on, so let's file, import current project, get the rod clamp, open this up. And now we'll align this part, click on it, go to align, and we want to drag this onto, snap that into place, flip it over, and click on done. Now we can rotate this part, double click on the part to rotate it, move the center to the hole, grab the curved arrow, and snap it into place. We've got a couple more parts, so let's show the casting again, and we're going to need to move this entire assembly down, but let's get some of the other parts in here first. The next step is to assemble the pin in here, and let's again turn off the casting to do this. We'll go to File, Import to Current, we'll bring in the pin, Open, Align, snap this into place. We'll go again to import another part, and this will be the piston itself. Now let's try to get the piston aligned on this pin. So we'll grab the inside face here, go to align, and grab this outside dot and pull that onto the pin. We can see this is headed the wrong direction, so we flip it. And as we move this up and down, we should get a coplanar arcs tooltip that shows up. Again, it's off by the amount of the chamfer. So let's move the amount of the chamfer, which is 0.03125, and say OK. And finally, we know we need to spin this 180 degrees. So that's good. Now this subassembly is all taken care of, but we still haven't got the subassembly located within the overall casting. So we can turn the casting back on and grab all of these parts, select one, shift select the last one, and reposition so we can see this, move it down into place. And now we've got our casting with all of these parts in the maximum position. And more than that, we have a list of the operations that it took to get here. If you don't want to see these, you can always turn off the display of the history, but the history will always be there. Remember also that if you want to delete one of these parts, you should really go to the history list to do that rather than the items list. Let's see what happens if we go back to the second part that we put into the assembly and just delete it from the items list. Okay, the rest of the parts stay there. That's what we would expect. But it shows up as a deletion in the history list rather than just deleting the part itself from the history list. Remember that Shapr3D is going to go through this list and recalculate everything in the list. And so the longer the list gets, the more things that it has to recalculate. So if you can do operations that you don't need to be history based without adding more items to the history list, you're better off. So instead of deleting that item from the items list, I should have deleted it from the history list. So let's Control Z to get that part back. Okay, and that gets rid of the delete item in the history list. Now we'll go to the import part up here, click on the dot dot dot, and do delete. And notice that now we're getting some errors because some of these functions have lost their references. To get that back, just hit Control Z and everything goes back the way it was.